Hey everybody, and welcome to this new free course on learning user interface design. If you want to learn UI design in Illustrator, I hope this video is helpful for you. In this video, I'm gonna show you how you can create simple and stunning mobile app using interface using a basics tool in Illustrator. I'm gonna explain to you the tips and tricks how you can easily work on UI design projects in Adobe Illustrator. If you are completely new to this and you are never use Illustrator or UI design, this video is really helpful for you to learn all the required skill sets. If you are already know Illustrator and graphic design, still this video is enjoyable for you. It will great value addition in your knowledge about Illustrator in UI design. If you want to learn graphic design, UX design, UI design, motion graphics, animation and drawing, and you want to improve your skill set in Adobe tools, make sure you subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon to get update about my upcoming and current videos. In this tutorial, we are going to create this simple mobile application user interface. We are going to use a lot of light color and the very bold and clean and clear text over here. We are also going to add the few icons over here, a few images and a couple of graphics over here. So that's the way we are going to complete this entire tutorial, and we are going to use few basic steps to complete this all the tutorial. First, we will create the very simple rectangle shapes using the wireframe. So we are going to use all the rectangle to create this. To create this tutorial, I'm gonna use these are the basics tools from this tool panel. So we are going to use the first selection tool, then direct selection tool, then pen tool, rectangle tool, and we are going to use this blend tool. So these are the essential tool we are going to use, primary we are going to use, like 80 to 90% tutorial will cover it with this tool. Other few tools we are going to use for the adding some more detail. So for this all tools, you can find a tutorial link in my description. So I have created detailed video tutorial for it. For that, first you need to watch how to create the new document. That tutorial is there. Then selection tool. Regarding this selection tool, all the shortcuts and information available over there. Then direct selection tool. So this tutorial also have the overview about the direct selection tool. Then pen tool, and then this is curvature tool. So this is all the tutorial is available over there. And then this is the shape tool. So this is most of the place we use the rectangle, so that come under the shape tool. So I have explained how you can take the rectangle and how you can modify that rectangle in this type tool. So how can you use the type tool, like how can you take the text over in Illustrator. And this one is blend tool, so I have used the blend tool. So this all the tutorial is available in my YouTube channel, and link is I just added in description. You can go and subsequently watch this tutorial if you want to get more detail about it. This shape tool, so this is most of the place we use the rectangle, so that come under the shape tool. So I have explained how you can take the rectangle and how you can modify that rectangle in this type tool. So how can you use the type tool, like how can you take the text over in Illustrator. And this one is blend tool, so I have used the blend tool. So this all the tutorial is available in my YouTube channel, and link is I just added in description. You can go and subsequently watch this tutorial if you want to get more detail about it. To keep this video tutorial short and sweet, I just have the demonstration about how you can create the rectangle. That video tutorial is available. So this is the my user interface mobile apps user interface tutorial I just created, and that link I have pasted in description. So here I have given how you can create the rectangle and how you can modify that rectangle in rounded corner. I also given the detail about how you can align this rectangle at the location where you want, how you can take the margin, like similar margin in surrounded for this rectangle. So all the details available in this tutorial. So this is very detailed tutorial for beginner I have created, and if you want to get more knowledge about it, so you can go and watch this tutorial. This tutorial I'm just adding some speed up, so I'm just created some time lapse for it, so adding some speed on it our, and the end stage we are going to look at into details. So through that we are going to complete this entire tutorial.
Thank you.
So we have completed our basic layout with the all the placement and the color everything. So we have the layout ready over here. Now we need to add the text as well as the remaining content, few icons and some graphics over here. To save our time, I just created all the graphic or collected all the icons over here, and then we are going to placing this top of our layout. So since we have the our all the layouts placement ready over here, so now we need to just place this text icon and the graphic in respective place. So that I'm going to show you how we can place and how we can complete this entire mobile app tutorial. So this place, these two icons will come over here. Before placing this, I just want to lock these two mobiles layers. So now this entire thing is only one group, so I need to ungroup this first. Now I have ungrouped this, and now you can see this first I need to lock this, then I want to lock this another one mobile, and then I need to check this. This is also I need to ungroup first, so I'm ungrouping this all. So you see, so now I have the lot of object as a single. So now I just want to do the placement of this icon. So I'm just taking this and placing on exactly top of it, and then I'm adjusting the selected this object, and the I'm aligning this into center. So then I need to adjust this little bit. Yeah, I have adjusted this. Now align remaining stuff. Then I'm going to align this search over here. So this is the way we are going to align all the element and the text in the exactly where we want. You can't move it based on the your requirement. You can add and then you can do the modification on that. So I'm just adding this icon. So since I placed all the very on the where we I want that location, so now I'm getting easy to just replace this over here. I have removed the other text over here, so I just want to delete this now. Then I'm just copying this, pasting over here, place this text over here. Exactly align into top of it. So see, now we have aligned all these things into exactly the location where we want. Now I just want to off this all the placeholder things. So to hide this, Control 3 is shortcut. You can press Control 3 or you can go inside here and you can manually off this specific layers. So you see this layer you can manually off over here. So once you select this layer, get this red square over here, so means that layer is selected, and then you can off this. So this is the different things in Illustrator and the Photoshop. Photoshop the entire layer gets selected, but here inside group that particular layer get square over here, so it's indicate that specific layer is get selected. Then I'm using the keyboard shortcut Control 3 to hide this. Then I want to hide this, I'm using the Control 3 is shortcut again here, Control 3. So if you remember keyboard shortcut, your life is easy and you can quickly perform the task in the less time. So here also I'm just Control 3. So we one more time we are going to check. So see, now our all the icon text placement we created and our look almost UI all the placement is ready over here. Now I'm going to add the text and icon for the another layout. So here I want to place this, so selected this and just I need to select these two object, then click on this. So this object, so it's like transform, you can see is aligned to key over here, and if I align this into over there, it's get aligned over there. Then I want to select this. So which key object you need to align, you need to one more time click that object, so then that object get selected over here. So first we need to select this two object first, then one more time if you click that object, it's get highlighted over here, and the object, the another object get exactly aligned with that key object. So now I'm going to place this entire in over here, so it's automatically get aligned. So now I just want to align this over here. I'm just dragging over here. So now my below layer is locked. I need to unlock this layer. So unlock layer is shortcut is Ctrl Alt 2. So if you press that, the layer get unlocked. And now I just selected this and I exactly placed center over here. And then I'm going to lock this below layers again. Ctrl 2 is shortcut for locking all the layers, and same I'm going to hide this another layout. Ctrl 3 is to hide this. If you're getting difficulty to select this, so you need to lock the top for all the objects and hide the below object. So see, now I'm getting difficulty to select the below object. So what I'll do, I'll just lock this text and I'm easily able to select the below layers over here, and I'm just pressing Ctrl 3 over here. So now you see we almost hide all the placeholder here and our layout is ready. So you see over here very quickly we have created this entire mobile layout with the all the elements. So if you work step by step, so you can easily create this kind of stunning layout. So you need to keep in mind first layout, color combinations and the alignment. So in this tutorial I just showing the how you can create and how you can get command on the Illustrator and all. So coming next tutorial I will show you how you can create the mood board, how you can create the icon, how you can create the, this kind of detail graphics in Illustrator, and then we will go slowly a little bit more complex kind of tutorial. This is the it in this entire tutorial. Please let me know your feedback in comment section. Press the like button if you like. If you not like, you press the dislike button as well, and please feel free to give your suggestion in comment section. So I'll look at into that. If you facing any difficulty to using Illustrator, or if you have any problem about the specific tool or some tool panel, so just let me know in comment section. I will resolve that query. If possible, I will come up with the YouTube tutorial, or otherwise I'll answer in your comment sections. I hope this video is helpful for you. As always, make sure you subscribe and hitting the bell button, because we have way more video coming up on this UI design course to take you next level. Please like this video and let me know your feedback in comment section. So well, see you in the next video.